What's up guys, it's Jordan here, back again with another Shadowverse video. I first of all apologize that I'm a little bit hungover, so my energy in this video is turned down a little bit. But aside from that, in this video I'm going to be featuring the new mid-range blood deck that came out after the Wonderland Dreams expansion. And so as you can see, this deck focuses, it's kind of a mix between the neutral package and solid blood cards. So we got the core neutral cards like Feria, Unica, Lirio, Goblin Leader, Alice, of course. And then you have your blood cards like Tove is an amazing card that blood receives and super good in this deck. Like a 2 cost for a 3/3 and it gains a rush if you play a neutral follower, which is super easy to combo with. Rapunzel's in here because it's just like a really strong stat line and it's really easy to activate, and it's got a cool synergy with Tove and Rapunzel. So if you go on turn 5, Tove, Rapunzel, they activate each other, which is kind of neat. One Grimnir is kind of like your finishing card. Baphomets are to pull your spawn of the abyss. Oftentimes, if you're not under pressure or you're ahead on board, you can Baphomet on 5 to get your spawn of the abyss to play on 6. And then you just win with Spawn of the Abyss on turn 6. I mean, you play it on turn 6 and then you pretty much win on turn 7. Happens a lot of times. Big Knuckle Bodyguard is an insane blood card. Destroys something with 3 or less defense. And when it evolves, it becomes a 5/6 rather than just a normal 4/5, which a lot of 4 cost evolves turn into. So Big Knuckle Bodyguard, great effect and good stat line. Scarlet Saboteur. Really good, deals 2 damage to remove something pretty much, and then you heal, and it also has Bane, which is really annoying a lot of the times. And then finally, the last new card we got is Emeralda. Emeralda is an insane card, destroys a follower or amulet, and you get a 4/5, and it gets Storm if you're in Vengeance. So if your opponent's not careful, and you have a spawn of the Abyss, and they think they're fine with just like a ward, and they put you under Vengeance to try to pressure you, you Emeralda it, and then Emeralda like gets that last bit of damage if your spawn doesn't kill them. So this is a deck, really powerful, and I definitely recommend trying it out if you haven't already. And if you enjoyed the video, make sure you subscribe and give this video a thumbs up, and check out my social media links in the description below and follow me on there. So thanks for tuning in guys, peace. Alright, we just throw back Rapunzel. Don't think we need her. We have a 2 and 3, we're going first. So whatever, unless it's Tove that he plays on turn 2, I should be able to trade and play Goblin later. Spiderweb is. Okay. I wonder if is this just going to be a Vengeance? Vengeance blood? Could also just be one of those aggro bloods that's not focused on the neutral package. Such an inefficient trade, but at least the goblins survive. DKB, pretty good for him here. So we can Scarlet and then trade the Goblin in. Alternatively, we have Fina, but Fina's not that great because it's going to go down to 2 health after the trade, and then he could use his own Scarlet. Could also Lirio, Evo, trade the Goblin, but if I'm trading Goblin, I might as well just Scarlet here. I don't see a point in evolving either. Now if he has a Scarlet, it doesn't really do much. It clears the board but takes his entire turn and an evil point. Not sure if I want to activate Vengeance right now. Okay. Well, he activated Vengeance himself, so now might as well just go in on it. Tove. The Tove lets me play it and Yunfina just trade in like that. Don't want to play Fina though? I think I do. Try to pick up a Belfigure. Nice. This is going safe. So I already have a 6-7 or a 6-1 and a 3-3. I think I'd rather just trade to Tobin like I originally planned. I'll be okay, he does have a revelation. Alright. Did I get debated this whole time? It's actually control blood? I mean, him being at 8 just means if I play Spawn of the Abyss and evolve it, he's pretty much just dead. There it is. I mean, he can't even revelation it anyways. It's not going to save you, man. Alright, this is a pretty solid time. We keep running into Bloods. Out of 5 games, this is like our 4th Blood. I'm trying to get variety for my video, come on guys. Alice would have been a great draw, but we have BKB anyways. Goblin leader here is just really weak because he can't even get over my BKB with it. I'm gonna trade with my Fina here, then double Goblin. So this way, if he has Scarlet, it doesn't really have not the greatest. Because if he's Scarlet, he can hit my Goblin Mage Evils into my Fina. Alright, that's fine. So next day we could just play Baphomet. Get our spawn. Ooh. That's tempting as well. We take this trade for sure. So if we go Alice, we push 5 damage this turn. Nah, I think Baphomet. This is like a really good turn for Baphomet. Alex would be okay because, like, I get a huge board out of it. But Spawn of the Abyss is like almost guaranteed a win against Blood. Because they don't have any like banishing or destruction effects for it. I should probably pre-evolve this, just so Revelation doesn't ruin my day. Going second, we'll just keep the Faria, just to have something to do on 2. I would have really liked to go first in this matchup, because it's likely going to be a neutral sword. And you really want to have the initiative in these board battle matchups. Ooh, he doesn't have anything on turn 2. That's really good for me. Because now I can challenge his Goblin Leader. If he had a 2-drop, he'd be able to trade into my 2-2, my Unica, and then play Goblin Leader. And then I wouldn't have a way to destroy it, so he would get an extra Goblin off of it. Alright, we'll just play Goblin Leader and pass here. Next turn we have Alice. Yep, so he has an Alice too. Most likely going double trade here. I wonder if I'm going to be able to Baphomet next turn. Baphomet into Evil, and then I play Spawn on 6. That's 16 damage on 7, plus my 2 on my Scarlet would be only 18, so that would be too off. So it's probably not worth it. But do I even have a better play? Not really, right? I guess I could go Goblin Leader and Actress. Nah, I think the bathroom is a bit better. I mean, if he starts hitting my face and puts me in vengeance, like an Emerald, I'll finish him. Yeah, that's a full board. Will he play around the vengeance? Oh, he didn't respect the vengeance. That's when you get punished. It's like what I was saying earlier. They don't respect it and they think they're protected by a ward. They get punished by Emerada. That's an OTK, guys.